In a devastating incident on Monday, a fire broke out at a lithium battery factory in Hwaseong, South Korea, resulting in the deaths of 22 workers. The blaze, triggered by multiple battery explosions, primarily claimed the lives of Chinese nationals, fire officials reported. The factory, operated by a primary battery manufacturer, is situated in an industrial cluster southwest of Seoul. The initial explosions and subsequent fire ravaged the facility, filling the area with extremely toxic gas that proved fatal for the workers within seconds. Fire officials stated that the cause of the explosion remains unclear. The fire, which started at 10:31, was largely extinguished after 6 hours of intense firefighting efforts. Among the deceased were 18 Chinese workers, 2 South Koreans and 1 Laotian, according to Kim Jin-yong, an official from the Hwaseong Fire Service. The nationality of the remaining victim has yet to be confirmed. 2 individuals are currently receiving treatment for major burns. Eyewitnesses and live TV footage depicted the chaotic scene as firefighters battled the blaze, spraying the damaged steel and concrete building. Parts of the structure had collapsed and significant sections appeared to have been blown out onto the street by the force of the explosions. Aerial views showed massive clouds of white smoke billowing from the site and explosions continuing to erupt within the building. Cho Sun-ho, a Gyeonggi province fire official, highlighted that most of the foreign workers killed were temporary hires who were likely unfamiliar with the building's layout. He noted that the rapid spread of smoke and flames left the victims with no chance to escape, stating that they likely succumbed after inhaling toxic gas just once or twice. South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol visited the scene later the day, and Interior Minister Lee Sang-min urged local authorities to take measures to prevent hazardous chemicals from contaminating the surrounding area. Established in 2020, Aricel manufactures lithium primary batteries for sensors and radio communication services and employs 48 people. The company is majority owned by S-Connect, which is listed on South Korea's Junior KOSDAQ Index. Following the incident, S-Connect's shares closed down by 22.5%. Industry experts noted that high casualty rate was primarily due to toxic materials involved rather than the burns.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.